Alfred's emissary spent a few days here. Someone may know where he went. Must be blocked from the other side.
I'm in no mood for wind belching, so choose your words well.
The king's emissary. I need to know where he went after he stayed here.
And I need to know why I've started getting boils under my armpits. Time will tell, eh?
Alfred's emissary. Where?
Him and the bard ended up in a copse by the bridge doing Lord knows what. Sounded like they were murdering a cat.
Singing?
If you say so.
For your relief!
You tried to catch flies, or would you ask something of me?
I'm looking for a man. He passed through here on the king's business.
Oh, bugger off, eh? Or I'll call the guards. I'm sick of people. You need to heal your own ills.
And people are sick of you.
For Jesus wept! Guards! Guards!
Hedain! Saints, preserve me!
What can I tempt you with? I hope to see you again soon.
I will see you later, friend.
I'm busy. Leave me be.
Loitering and lollygagging.
I'm looking for someone. An emissary from Alfred. Have you seen such a man?
Ooh, la-di-da. Listen to you, all high and mighty. Get away with you, you valley lily.
Tell me what you know, or this will go badly.
For you, maybe. I'll be dead and you still won't know a thing.
You're a strange fish. Did you see the man or not?
I did. He was getting pie-eyed with that bard Gowan and causing quite a ruckus. They left together. See? That wasn't hard, was it?
Harder than it should have been.
There was a bard drinking with the emissary. I should find him. See if he knows anything. Zunin, guide me.
I'll send you to your heathen hell!
That ill-swarmed scarp can't have gone far.
Patience is a tired horse. Ploddity plod plod.
Another tottering teat sucker who can't hold his drink. Let's clear your head.
Why do you smite me so? Oh, God's truce! Fie on you! Oh, what infernal wakes me?
Are you the tail weaver?
Gawain the dandelion. For the seeds of my stories flit upon the winds of Wessex. But why, mule, do you kick my noggin?
You and Alfred's emissary were drinking in the tavern. Tell me where he went.
Were we? I was so ale-addled. Perhaps a small and silver thing upon my palm might help me recall?
How about something long and sharp in your gut?
All right, no need for that. You paint a vivid picture, Dane. He was headed to the White Coast to the southeast, Dover Fortress. He said it is where they train those religious fanatics, zealots. They pray all night instead of sleeping.
My thanks. And in return, wisdom. Too much beer-bibing will grow a fool in wit and words.
My thanks, Weaver of the Obvious. Now leave me to my unholy punishment.
Emissary made for Dover Fortress on the southeast coast.
or my brother die!
Winters for you.
Better to die than face my lords. I hope my Magister Magnus forgives me. For so long, I looked to him for guidance, for order.
If your honor is slow, a true lord cannot forgive you. They cannot.
Now I will turn my gaze to Warden, Tiwar, and Shunor. I will continue to turn until I find some forgiveness.
You will spin and drill yourself to an endless bottom. It should work.
Thank you. Ibien cam for into septimo. Inoculo electae.
The emissary is somewhere here. Perhaps I can find the letter without bloodshed. The Bard said paladins trained at this fortress. This will not be an easy fight. Abbot Cunibert will want to know. I should meet Basil and the Abbot in Falkenstone. Survey the area, Sudan. I should meet Basim and the Abbot in Falkenstone. Show me what lies ahead.
Catch
the monks. Oh, you must try my
Eivor. You have news?
Kent's new elderman will be Thane Tedmund.
Tedmund? Oh, the Lord is testing me. He is made mouse by you Danes. Barely leaves his fortress at Rusister. How might I gain his influence if he will not speak to me? Or to anyone? 'Tis a puzzle.
To inspire loyalty, Tedmund must owe you something, such as his life.
Go on.
A fortress stormed, a man kidnapped. If you beat back his enemy, saved him from sure death, his gratitude would...
swell. It would know no bounds. But that fortress will be harder to pry open than a nun's knees.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Are you hiding something, Bathum?
There is a lumber mill nearby, correct?
Beamersfield. Alfred invests much in fortifying Wessex, and uses our forests to do so. The mill provides his wood.
Tedmund is there.
Impossible! How do you know?
I heard rumors that Tedmund had been lured out of self-exile to manage work on the fortifications of Canterbury.
Taking him from a lumberyard is less dangerous than assaulting a fortress. But your rescue attempt will not have the same flair. Is it worth it?
It may still work. Yes. Yes. Bring him to the megaliths.
And Fulke?
When I have Tedmund's fealty, you shall have Fulke. Now go. I will rustle up a small rescue party.
One more time, I'm telling you. If he says my boots are dirty or my hair needs combing, I will split him up.
You're full of swamp gas.
Thunderverse Efton Yin on Efton!
I'm wary of this abbot, Bethan. He is self-serving and evasive. Can he really deliver Fulke?
The abbot is a friend of Fulke's. That is clear.
So long as he doesn't suspect our motive, we may have a chance.
Indeed. This brings to mind a story. Perhaps you've heard of it. The Scorpion and the Frog.
A children's story?
A cautionary tale. The Scorpion. A cautionary tale. The Scorpion wants to cross the river, but he cannot swim, so he enlists the help of the Frog. The Frog agrees to carry him on his back, extracting a promise that the Scorpion will not sting him.
Let me guess. The Scorpion reneges, blaming his nature, and both drown.
The scorpion crosses the river and stings an innocent man, killing him. So what does this tale tell us?
That your stories are clouded and their meaning doubly so?
It shows that every tale has 1,000 possible outcomes, many of which are surprising. If the abbot does not deliver Fulke, he will die at my hand. And we will continue our search.
A sobering approach.
You prefer to work in the shadows? Bemisfield is just ahead. Lead. I will follow.
What do you see, Isunin? This chase will catch us a plump hen.
Once the abbot has Tedman's gratitude, he will deliver Fulke. It will cost us nothing more than this.
If that leaden wit keeps his word.
No escape!
Stop caterwauling and you'll live.
Live? Oh, saints, protect me!
Silence will save you, Tedman. Silence, not your saints.
Flee, my friend. We have the man we came for. Does this venture not set your blood ablaze?
You don't prefer working in the shadows?
And so we have. To steal a man, take him with swiftness, and escape without anyone on our heels? We hide in plain sight. Such is our way. But only until the moment of success, the final strike.
I prefer to act and speak plain. Kings and lords who do not are often misunderstood.
Yet as a leader yourself, you cannot deny that subtlety and intrigue are a cloak you must wear. How many of your clan know the true circumstances of Sigurd's absence? You see my point. A leader must... My point. A leader must know when to speak and when to stay silent. For silence is not always a lie.
It can feel like one. You truly embrace the concept of hiding in plain sight, eh? To its very fullest.
As I do in everything.
Danes, in the name of Alfred, King of Wessex, I demand you release his royal subject into my care.
Come no closer, Christian, else your man dies by my blade.
Please, I'm not the man you want.
Keep your eye on this one. He'll be worth a hefty bounty.
Any false moves, and I will snip your heels.
We have your man. Now let's finish this shadow play and be gone.
Are you sure that's Tedmund? He's dressed as a lord, but that man is shorter and fatter than I recall.
I'm not Tedmund. I'm not. I swear upon the holy rood, I am not Thane Tedmund.
What in heaven's name is happening here?
Who are you? Speak quickly, or I will slit your throat and leave you for the crows.
Shergar. I'm called Shergar. Lord Tedmund pays me a measly coin to serve as his double.
Brother Shergar, you are far from Augustine's Priory.
I left the cloisters many moons ago, Your Holiness. The monastic life was not my calling.
We can use you yet, Shergar. Summon Tedmund to a meeting. Get him out in the open.
Tedmund has no care for me or what I have to say. My orders come by letter, never by mouth. I hardly know the man.
You have no use to us, then. Perhaps I should just kill you here and now.
No, wait. Let me think. Let me think. Danes. To storm the walls, you need Danes. There's a raiding camp west of here I was told to be wary of. Acting as Tedmund, I ordered a band of soldiers to capture them. If you hurry, you may be able to stop this.
If another band of Danes wants to join our assault, we'll have the distraction we need to get inside Rucester.
If the Saxons don't slaughter them first.
I am still Tedmund to the men in the field. I could speak with their captain, send his men away.
It's a fearless plan.
The Nornir knit winding paths that cannot be unknotted. It seems Rucester was always in our path. Abbot, stay alert. We'll send word when we're ready to capture Tedmund.
And this fool? He knows much of our plan.
He'll come with us. And if he betrays me, I'll roast his balls over a roaring fire.
You will not regret this. My wily ways and quick wit will cease the need for bloodshed.
I still might kill you yet, man, if your prattling doesn't cease.
The rewards for being Tedmund are rapidly diminishing.
And how does one become a double? Are there vigorous challenges and tests to overcome?
I was born with the misfortune of looking like someone else. I should have stayed on God's chosen path.
What took you from it?
I'm the seventh son of a poor farmer. And not wanting another mouth to feed, my father gave me to the monks.
The cloistered life did not suit you?
I thought there would be great comfort in repetition. But instead I found nothing but prayer and backbreaking toil.
The Norns weave strange destinies. Now your life depends on the story you weave for yourself.
I am not a good forgery. Still tis leaden, my hands sweat, and I have a stutter when I'm nervous, but I will try.
Ah, the cornerstone of all great art.
The captain does not know Tedmund well. If we keep our heads, he will not question my orders. I hope.
We are too late. There is great horror here.
Those who remain must be saved, whatever the cost.
Let us approach the captain with caution. He drinks too much and does not need a reason to kill us. Yes, it is I, Thane Tedmund, coming to discuss the orders I gave to you not one day ago.
This hamhock will get us all killed. Most
interesting. You murdered our people! Men, women, children!
Pipe down, you dogs! You're slaves of Kent now!
Okay. Huh. Thane Tedmund! What are you doing here?
How dare you address me in such a defiant manner? Do you not know who I am?
You are Tedmund, as I've said. And I mean no disrespect, Lord, but I was told you were back in Rucester.
Oh, yes? And do I look like I'm in Rucester?
You do not, sir.
A wise man is always unexpected.
You travel in strange company, Lord. An Arab and a Dane.
To hell with this talk. Let Saxon blood soak this land.
We owe you our lives, friend. These Saxon whore sons would have killed us all.
Yes, they would have. And now's your chance to hit back. March with us on Rucester and drain it of riches.
I would gladly, friend. But we few will not break those iron-thick walls.
And we have no allies in Wessex. None who could be called upon to attack their countrymen.
Mercia will heed the call. Giedrich will provide our Viking a horde. We'll send a message to Oxenfordshire. The men of Mercia would gladly take a swipe at Wessex. What is your name, warrior?
Runa Egilsdottir.
We need ships, Runa.
We have a small fleet moored upriver, but a naval chain blocks passage to Rucester's walls.
I will remove it, and your people will bring their ships. Now, gather these fallen weapons and armor. Giedrich and the men of Oxenfordshire will need them to hide their Mercian origins.
My warriors were denied Valhalla today. I cannot bear the idea of gifting their weapons to more Saxons.
Their sacrifice was great. Their gift will be all the greater.
They will know justice with our victory. It will calm their restless shades, I promise. Will your men bring the armor to the battle?
And what is our plan?
In the morning, you will go to Buckingham, remind Giedrich of his promise. When you have his bond, meet me on the shore near Rucester, with the ships.
Abbot Cunibert must be warned in advance. He'll need time to muster his rescue party.
Runa, that is your task. I will tell you where to meet him before you leave.
All seems in order. At first new light, I will leave.
Good. That gives us time to drink.
You've traveled so far to carry out your duty. Is this the life of a hidden one? Always on the move?
No. Mine is not the usual path. The creed does travel. Our ideals are universal. We believe that.
So there's nowhere you call home?
No place I call home. No.
Weird.
For me, home is family. But I have no family.
No one? Not even Hytham?
Parents, brothers, all dead.
I lost my parents when I was 9 winters along. Without Sigurd, I would have...
There is always one unbreakable bond.
Yes.
Children. They bewilder you. They can cause you so much worry. Fill you with joy. Even stop your heart. And if you're lucky, they replace you. I was not so lucky. I had a son. I miss him terribly. Even now.
I'm sorry, Basim.
He was taken from me. By someone I trusted. A friend. A mentor. A man who I would trust with anything. But a man you trust with anything can take everything.
Rucesta will not be an easy nut to crack. Time to prepare. See you, my friend. Best not to draw attention here.
What's all that about?
Clear this fort and break this chain to get our ship safely upriver. The mechanism should be inside.
It's not a good day to be the Thane.
Suffer!
With the chain down, Giedrich and the ships can get through.
Eivor, we await your orders.
You brought your weapons and armor?
Aye, Raven Tamer.
Good. Now we dig in and wait for our friends. Well met, old friend.
When the chance arrived to lodge an axe in the sod of Wessex, you thought of me. Such an honor.
Is everything else in place, Eivor? Are we ready to take Rusister?
Rally our army. We will drag this mouse from his hole.